Hello everyone, my name is Jason Cassel, and I am one of two graduate students on this continent studying piano technology. Yes, Florida State's College of Music is the only university in this nation and continent that offers a graduate level degree in what is called piano technology, or in other words, piano tuning, rebuilding, design, repair, etc. So you're probably wondering, what does someone with such a degree even research? Well, I have about 3 minutes and 30 seconds to tell you, but I'll need your help. First, if you will, just tap lightly with the tip of your finger on your desk or the arm of your chair. Now tap with the knuckle. Hear the difference? Now this difference is pretty straightforward. The tip of your finger is softer than the knuckle of your finger. Simple, right? Well, let's take it a step further. When you press a key on a piano, it engages a hammer that moves and strikes the strings, exciting the piano and making the sound. This hammer can be softer or harder, and that will affect the tone. And this is done intentionally. Harder hammers sound a certain way, softer hammers sound a certain way. So this picture here is showing how we as piano technicians can alter how hard or soft those felts are. It's done by inserting a tiny needle into specific locations on the piano hammer. This will affect how tightly compacted those felts are and change the sound. This can be done on a note-to-note basis in a piano and can be done anywhere. This is not a new concept. It's known as voicing, and piano technicians have been doing it for some time. There's a good amount of literature and research done about how this process should be done. The problem is most of it functions in what I call the realm of obscurity, which is this place where they never quite narrow in on what exactly is happening. Well, the Steinway & Sons guide goes so far as to say that voicing cannot be measured. But I submit that it can. In fact, I believe I have successfully done so here at Florida State in my research. I have taken a piano into a recording studio on campus and recorded it before and after needles were inserted at various locations in the hammer. From there, I was able to take those recordings, analyze them inside of a computer program, and make graphs that demonstrate visually the spectrum changes for that particular note. Or in other words, what changed? Why does it sound different? I was able to isolate this down to the acoustical level, something that has never been done. Together, I collected the text, audio, and graphics and submitted them for publication, and they should hopefully, at least my hope is, be published by the end of this year in the Piano Technician's Journal. At least so they tell me. What I was able to do is create graphics that look something like this. And while this graphic might not look revolutionary to you, this first blue line on the top shows what the hammer sounded like before I did anything to it. The orange line then shows what happened when I put the needle in one location, the gray line in another, and the yellow in another. I was able to isolate these changes, and to a piano technician, the differences between these lines is inspiring. For the first time ever, they're able to see what they're doing and understand what's happening acoustically. The scientific is meeting the practical in a way that has never been done in the 300 years of the piano and was made possible because of the resources of this unique program at Florida State. I personally believe that as piano technicians come to understand their craft, they'll be able to more fully provide pianists with what they need to create the music that can inspire us all. Thank you.